Supervisors on August 14th, 2012. We're going to have a report out from a closed session first, and then we'll go ahead and.
Mr. Carbone?
Here.
Ms. Wolf?
Here.
Ms. Gray?
Present.
Ms. Farr?
Here. Would you all please rise with me for the Pledge of Allegiance?
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay. Thank you very much.
As the boys learn their excellent soccer skills, sportsmanship, and teamwork from their amazing coaches, Jose Acosta and Sarah Andrade. Now, therefore, be it hereby ordered and resolved that this Board of Supervisors recognize all.
Thank you. We'll put you out this way so you don't have to walk through the crowd. Thank you. One, I would just like to continue, and that's 0002421. So, if we could just continue that another week. So if there's nothing else on that, maybe we could have a motion to approve that one, just minus that one budget revision. The motion?
Okay.
Motion?
Okay.
Second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. All right. And then A12. Who wanted to speak to A12?
Madam Chair.
Thank Supervisor Gray. She came up with a great idea. Supervisors have done this before, but I just thought it was a really great thing. She planned and put together a luncheon.
All right. That concludes the administrative agenda. We have a motion to approve the balance of the items. Madam Chair will make a motion. She serves as the executive.
Madam Chair, members of the board, our first speaker is William Wagener, followed by Andrew Wilson.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's a very rare thing that I ever come to speak to you, but I have a very important thing to tell you today. In 2005, for my own television show, I attended virtually every day of the Michael Joe Jackson trial put on in this county in Santa Maria. I didn't realize until it was over that I was the only person in the media that actually attended virtually every day of the trial because the national media was rotating in two-week shifts. What I witnessed in that was not simply that Michael Joe Jackson, the most famous person on the planet, and presumably one of the wealthiest and best-known celebrities of our county, was actually the victim of multiple crimes during the trial. Not only was he not guilty, but the prosecutors, in fabricating evidence, actually committed crimes. And it would be hard for you to walk in and watch the trial for one day and to notice that, because you had to watch it day in and day out, week after week. I have an affidavit of criminal conduct to present to you. And I have to present it to you because in our form of government, when one branch of government totally fails to do its job correctly, and that's what happened, the judicial branch correctly came to the conclusion that Michael Joe Jackson was totally and completely not guilty, not only of the 10 felonies originally charged by Thomas Sneddon, but also of the lesser 4 misdemeanors they snuck in at the end, trying to beg the jury to give him some kind of victory. The 3 felonies that I observed firsthand and have firsthand knowledge are fingerprint evidence, fabrication. The magazine had not been printed till 4, 5, 6 months after the
war. I'm sorry, Mr. Wagner, your time is up.
Thank you. I'll just give these to so you each have a copy. One for each of you. The felonies are listed there and I hope you will ask for a special prosecutor.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Next speaker, please.
Yeah, thank you. My name is Andrew Wilson, and I have an arrangement with the Michael Jackson estate. This book here is called The Broken Heart Stone, most famous handprint in history. As you know, me and my wife had arranged a situation where we owned the handprints, footprints, and autographs, and handprint of Michael Jackson in cement. It is now outside the Chinese Theater. It is currently in the process of a documentary. Right now it's in the works, and I've talked with Mr. Wagener, and what he says is not just a local issue, it's really resonating around the world, and I intend to make it a part of the documentary, because there's some elements involved there in which one part of our governmental system has let us down, and we're really entrusting you voted members to hopefully carry the torch to the next level to investigate it. Because, like I said, I'm going to make it a part of the book. I believe it's an important part, where there's a possibility that the system was abused by those in power. So, with that said, thank you for your investigation into Mr. Wagner's matter.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good morning. I'm here just to follow up on what Mr. Willen Wagner was talking about. I'm also representing not just fans and devoted fans, but people who see the truth, and we are, including myself, we believe in the justice system, and we believe the truth will always prevail, but in this case, as far as the behavior and conduct of the prosecuting team headed by Tom Sneddon, it was not. I believe if you're going to be, if you have any personal issues or prejudice, it does not belong in a position of that kind of power. We are appointed to defend and do the right thing. And justice should have been served. And there's court records to indicate the felonies, several of them, that was present at those months during 2005, during Michael Joseph Jackson's trial. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, how are you today? First thing I would like to say is thank you for having me. I would ask that you would appoint a special prosecutor to indict Tom Sneddon. I feel like Michael Jackson's name was drugged through the mud. His name was tarnished, something that he worked for his whole life. Especially as an entertainer, that's very important to a person. That's their whole livelihood, it's their name. And as an African American, it's very important from the time that he came up that he had a name. And I think that also led to his untimely death. I think there were other parties involved that did help in his death, but I believe that he got on the profile fall and he was put in a vulnerable position because of all the stress that he went through and all the things that he went through. And he couldn't even sleep at night. And, you know, he was already sick and had other problems that aided in that problem and him being able to sleep. And I feel these evil men, Tom Sneddon and Ron Zonin, maliciously fabricated evidence against one of the most childlike and innocent men, Michael Jackson. You didn't know them, but you know Tom Sneddon fabricated false evidence committing 3 felonies. We the people have read the court record, and it is clear. Susan Yu and Thomas Mesro left a clear and convicting record that the 4 prosecutors committed fraud on the court and failure by the Santa Barbara District Attorney Office to prosecute one of their own is going and continuous fraud on the court, and that stops the statute of limitations. So indict Tom Sneddon, Zonin, and all of them. We're asking for justice. There's blood on their hands. This man didn't do anything deserving what happened to Michael Jackson. He was already acquitted in the court of law, and we already had him acquitted by God because he was a good man and did nothing but help children. I went to Neverland when I was a child. I saw it firsthand. He was a humanitarian. He deserved better than that, and God knows the truth, and I hope that you guys will accept the truth and indict Tom Sneddon for what he did to Michael Jackson. It was unjust. Thank you.
Thank you. Hello. I would like to say that the Viso family used their children to coerce them to bring fraud against not only Michael Jackson, but J.C. Penney's and several celebrities, which was also brought out in court. They and Tom Sneddon ignored this fact, and he brought all this against Michael Jackson without the approval of the Child Protective services or even the police. He jumped all of that and he decided to bring charges against Michael Jackson. It seemed like it was a personal that he had against him. All of this is a crime against the public, and so therefore there should be an investigation to see all the things that he did. And also the semen was also Michael Jackson's semen. It seems that there was some fraud regarding that it may not have even been Michael Jackson's semen. And so there needs to be a great investigation to find out about all these different things that happened. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Daniel Rivier. I was a long time friend of Michael Jackson's. I'm from Australia. I met him in 1996 when he toured Australia, and we remained close friends up to when he died. And at no point through our relationship did I see anything that, like Tom Sneddon was portraying in court. He never even suggested anything of any such manner. And I really feel that from, you know, years before that, Tom Sneddon was gunning for him, and he definitely was gunning for him in 2005. And if this is the only thing I can do for Michael today, I just want to make the point that Michael was a good man, and you really need to indict Tom Sneddon. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ty Pernick. It's so very clear the District Attorney's Office has clear conflict of interest and never indicted their own people for fraud on the courts and the three felonies committed by Thomas Sneddon, Ron Zeelan, and Gordon Antulos. We, the people of California, the people of the United States of America, and the entire world, demand that you appoint a special prosecutor to investigate the four evidence fabricating prosecutors. Get them prosecuted and put in prison where they belong. I'm the founder of tmichaeljackson.com. I have in excess of 45 members on Facebook, and I have in excess of 22,000 followers on Twitter. Around the world, it's clear and evident to all of us that not only Michael Jackson fans, advocates, and fighters for the truth, that something very wrong happened during that trial. It would be an injustice to yourselves as board members of Santa Barbara to overlook that. Sorry, I'm a bit anxious. I don't mean to.
As a
mother of five children, I've always taught my children to be truthful, to stand up for what's right. My daughter, who's here today, was a victim of bullying at school 4 years ago. She was hit, but she never spoke up. Since she has witnessed my advocacy for the past 4 years, now she stands up for bullies. She speaks up for the bullies. She took it to the principal, and her own friends told her, you either be our friend or you be with the person that was bullied.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your time.
Hi, my name is Bree Zelda. Anyone who reads the court record can see that it's clear that Tom Sneddon, Ron Zeelan, and their team committed fraud on the court. Also, Christine Stanley and Joyce Dudley, who took over their position as a district attorney, they have continued to cover up they've continued to cover up by not charging all of the district attorneys that were involved for making false evidence. Appoint a special prosecutor and put him into jail, because I'm really surprised that someone that is so high in government can provide something false and get away with it.
Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Leslie Cole. I'm here because on behalf of William Wagner, the holy life in the world wants justice done. Justice is the only to be had when Tom Sneddon